سيدنا محمد behind the whole month. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it clear, but to worship me. So this is the purpose. ولذلك يا إخوة مقاصد الشريعة والدين, the objective or the holistic aims of the religion is to protect the deen. This is number one on the list out of the five. طيب, a lot of us don't know that there is an objective behind worshiping Allah. So when you worship Allah, you're supposed to achieve something. What is it? What is it? يا أيها الناس اعبدوا ربكم. This is the first call in Surah Al-Baqarah, the short page, then the second page, it's on the third page. After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala categorized mankind into three: muttaqeen, then disbelievers, then hypocrites, the three types of people. Then comes in the call, Ya ayyuha an-nasu, O mankind, اعبدوا ربكم, worship your Lord, الذي خلقكم, the one who created you. So he created you to worship him. لعلكم what? تتقون. So you may achieve taqwa. So again, the purpose of the creation is to do what? To do what? Worship. طب, what is the purpose behind worshiping Allah? Is to achieve taqwa. وانظر الصوم, five verses in Surah Al-Baqarah. Look. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. O ye who believe, look at the fifth verse. Look at the ending of it. كذلك يبين الله آياته للناس لعلهم يتقون. So those are the five verses. The first verse ended with تتقون, and the last verse ended with what? يتقون. So the purpose is what? تقوى. شوف, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spoke about the qurbani, the dhabih that you offer in the day of Eid, or if you're in Hajj, al-Hadi, شوف, لن ينال الله لحومها ولا دماؤها. When you slaughter that qurbani, does Allah get any of the blood or any of the meat? ولكن يناله التقوى منكم. But what he wants from you when you perform the act is to have taqwa. When you go and pick that qurbani, you look for what? This is for Allah. Not like the Cain, you know, Qabil and Habil, you know, Cain and Abel, their story. One of them went and grabbed what? But the other one went and I picked what? A nice qurbani. You go and pick nice one and you take care of it, and when you slaughter it, you do it according to the sunnah. And this is ذلك ومن يعظم شعائر الله فإنها من تقوى القلوب. So again, ya ikhwa, this message is repeated over and over again in the Quran and in the Sunnah, that the purpose, the objective, translation of the Quran, Salman, you know, you look at how the people translated yattaqoon, muttaqeen, they really have a very hard time to cover what the meanings of this concept in one word, because you're supposed to produce one word. You can't do that. And this is how you realize how the Torah and the Gospel, one of the ways that it got distorted, translation. Because you cannot transfer a term in one language into another language, because the people don't have that. Because you need to understand this, the language is a product of a culture, is the final outcome of a culture. The word goes down deep into the culture of the people who speak this language. ولذلك وما أرسلنا من رسول إلا بلسان قومه. We have not sent deals how some of our righteous predecessors defined taqwa. علي بن أبي طالب رضي الله عنه said, التقوى هي الخوف من الجليل. تقوى is to fear Allah سبحانه وتعالى. But not the fear which sends you to despair. That's not what we want here. But the fear to get you to what? والعمل بالتنزيل. That you act upon the revelation. Some people fear and say, Allah is not going to forgive me. I'm too sinner, man. It's too much. I don't think I have a chance with Allah. I'm not going to pray. خلاص. لا. That's one of the ways of shaitan to you. Because shaitan himself fallen into this trap. When he realized that he really overdid it, when he refused to bow down, he said, I have no chance. ولذلك Iblis, the name Iblis, which is the original name of shaitan, is a derivative of a noun in Arabic called Al-Balas. What is Al-Balas? Despair. So Iblis, actually the name is what? Coming from where? Originates from where? Despair. فشيطان is going to come to you, man, look at you, you've been doing all this bad stuff. Oh, Allah is going to get you big time and you have no... No. فعلي بن أبي طالب is saying, fear that sends you to what? To repent, to come back to Allah, huh? To act, to strive, to be a good Muslim. والرضا بالقليل أو القناعة بالقليل, and that you're contented with the little. Don't be greedy about life. Don't... Alhamdulillah, يعني if you have enough to live, and here is the most important thing, والاستعداد ليوم الرحيل, and you're always in a state of readiness to go. Can you guarantee that you're not going to die now? Can you? Can you guarantee that you're not going to die tomorrow? Then you should be what? Ready for death. So this is Ali ibn Abi Talib. Obviously, he based it on the consciousness of Allah, that you know Allah, huh? And you act upon, and don't you know this world is going to end? It's a beautiful concept. طيب, I have three more to go. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. What Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said about the taqwa? أن يطاع فلا يعصى وأن يذكر فلا ينسى وأن يشكر فلا يكفر. Having taqwa, that you obey Allah, you strive to obey Allah and never disobey Him. And if you disobey, what should you do? Go back. And that you always remembering Allah, وأن يذكر, never forget Allah سبحانه وتعالى. هذه التقوى. وأن يشكر فلا يكفر. Show that you're grateful for the bounties. قل الحمد لله. Say الحمد لله. For the bounties that Allah bestowed upon you. Three. We have one more to go. And you can go home after that. You'll be free then. Abu Huraira was asked, Ya Aba Huraira, O Aba Huraira, what is it taqwa? What is the meaning of التقوى? He responded by asking the questioner, هل مشيت على طريق فيه شوك? Have you ever walked on a way, on a road, where there are thorns, glass, harmful objects on the road? Imagine you're walking on the road and there is what? Things that can what? Harm your feet. قال نعم. He said, yeah. قال ما فعلت? What did you do? You know what the person did? I protected myself from the thorns, from the harmful things. He said, this is التقوى. What are these harmful things? Sins. So you're staying away from what? Sinning. This is التقوى. ولذلك one of the شعراء, one of the poet, used that conversation between أبي هريرة and the questioner, and he said, خلي الذنوب صغيرها وكبيرها فهو التقى. Leave off sins, whether it is minor or major. This is what taqwa is. واصنع كماش فوق أرض الشوك يحذر ما يرى. And do like the person who's walking on a pathway filled with thorns, and he's avoiding it. ولا تحقرن صغيرة. And don't ever belittle a sin. Why? فَإِنَّ الْجِبَالَ مِنَ الْحَصَى. Because mountains are made of what? Small stones. هذا أبو هريرة. طيب. The last one, which is really the most, I would say, comprehensive. طلق بن حبيب رضي الله عنه. He says, التقوى أن تعمل بطاعة الله على نور من الله ترجو ثواب الله وأن تترك معصية الله على نور من الله تخاف عقاب الله. That you engage in the obedience of Allah. You strive to be obedient. Do this, yes. Do this, yes. Do this, yes. Do this, yes. سمعنا وطعنا. سمعنا وطعنا. سمعنا وطعنا. سمعنا وطعنا. سمعنا وطعنا. But listen. على نور من الله. That command must come from who? Allah and His Messenger. Don't make up stuff. Don't innovate. Nur min Allah, it must come with wahi. Allah will tell you what you need to do. Don't make up stuff. And when you do it, hope that you will get rewarded. That you want Jannah. You want Allah forgiveness. Don't do it because well, it's good. It's la. You're wanting what? الاحتساب, what we call الاحتساب. And this is also one of the objectives of, you know, of العبادة, that you're worshipping Allah because you want Jannah. There is nothing wrong with that. In the other hand, you abandon the disobedience of Allah. Don't do this. سمعنا وطعنا. Don't say, no, what's wrong with it? I'm going to do it. Don't say, oh, well, it's America. We got to do it here. You know, no. No. Just say سمعنا وأطعنا. If you're weak يا أخي, that's fine. Make tawbah and go back. على نور من الله. على نور من الله. But also according to the revelation. Have you ever heard about the people who say that they are vegetarians? Huh? Listen, if you don't want to eat meat, that's okay. Nobody told, but don't make it a religion. Because Allah made meat halal. يا أيها الذين آمنوا لا تحرموا طيبات ما أحل الله لكم. Oh, ye believe, do not harmize ميك حرام يعني وات الله وات ميت حلال فور يو. Listen, if you don't like to eat meat, that's okay. It's fine. But don't turn it into what? Into a sunnah, into a religion. You know, when you say I'm a vegetarian, that means what? You're saying what? لا, there is nothing. Is it unlawful to eat meat? لا, package. Consciousness of Allah in Ramadan. You don't eat, you don't drink, and you're careful about this. Wake up in the morning, suhoor, salatul fajr in the masjid, go to work, you try to pray in the masjid dhuhr, come for iftar, isha in the masjid, taraweeh, repeat for 30 days. It's like a factory to produce out of you what? Stay away from that, don't look, don't be mean to the people, abandon falsehood. If you don't abandon falsehood, why are you fasting? It's a program, concentrated program in 1 month to get you. It's like a training. It's like you're going to go. So that should feed you what? The rest of the year. And that is why if you neglect Ramadan, and that is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, خَابَ وَخَسِرْ. May he lose. Who? من أدرك رمضان ولم يغفر له. The dua by Jibreel. Jibreel made this dua and Rasul said Ameen to it. The one who lives until Ramadan and he doesn't take advantage of what? Of that training camp. And Allah is going to help you. Listen, shaitan, jinn, I'm going to chain them for you. You will find a lot of people, more people. So look, Salat al-Asha, you're going to see in 20 days, Salat al-Asha here. How many people are here? In Ramadan, people that you never see. I'm going to bring you more people so to encourage you. So now don't waste the opportunity. جزاكم الله خيرا. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك. أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت. أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. والحمد لله رب العالمين.